Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here to review An Unkindness of Ghosts by Rivers Solomon. This is a sci-fi novel by a woman of color. If you watched my TBR haul video, you know that I was really excited to give this a read. I hadn't heard anything about it. This came out this year, but the cover was just breathtaking. Like, when I saw that cover, I was like, oh my gosh, what is this? And then I just thought, I was like, I want to read it. I just want to know what the heck this is about. I did not expect to fall in love with this as much as I did. I gave this a 4 stars on Goodreads, and I feel like this is a true 4-star read. I mean, let me just get into the general gist. So when I started the book, will you believe that I started it and at first I was like, oh, this is going back to the library. I couldn't get into it. Literally, I read like the first maybe 7 or 8 pages and I was like, okay, this is like such weird talking and like I'm not following the language. I'm gonna put this down and I'm gonna read another book and I'm gonna read another book. And then I didn't have any other books necessarily that I could read that I hadn't read yet. So I was like, let me try this again. So I picked up where I left off, and I promise you, by that next chapter, I couldn't put the book down. I was like warped, and I was like, was something wrong with me when I started the book, or did it just take a while to set the tone? I'm not sure still, but once it gets going, I mean, this gets going. One of the most beautiful aspects of this, it touches on friendships, and who's your parents and who do you like when you choose your family kind of. I thought it was just okay to really explain. I'll go to the backtrack. This follows the journey of a young girl, Aster, who never knew her mother. So she's always had this longing to know who her mother was, what her mother was, and all this other stuff. But on top of all of that, just being one of her personality things, she also is someone who is very androgynous. People don't really know what to classify her as. She is a female, but she doesn't necessarily subscribe 100% to female identity. Like, her body is just very strong. You kind of find out later on some of the hormonal stuff that causes her to not really express a lot of things that are typically classified as female. But it's also very interesting because not only that, she is attracted to women, but she's also attracted to a guy, and it's like, it's a lot of stuff in it. But anyways, on that whole thing, Aster's really oppressed because she's basically a slave. I mean, they're in space, so they don't call them slaves, but they have this hierarchy level razor thing where she's on one of the lower decks of the floor, and basically that's coded by your skin tone. So this also deals with like colorism and just racism in general, and basically how like the lower deckers, they're all like dark, coarser hair, and like just are seen as ugly, barbaric, and are not given the same privileges. They're denied like basic health access, and like it's just a lot. Anyways, it sounds like I'm rambling because there's so many aspects, but there's so many aspects to her character because she's also really into science and really into like the medical field. And she gets the opportunity to be an understudy to someone who is in the medical field and is a doctor. And he is someone who's white passing, not white, but white passing. And like the privileges that he gets because of that. And I mean, I can go on and on about this book. Like, it's hard to talk about this book to someone who hasn't read it, even though that's what these reviews are for. But what I will say is, if you have read this, comment below and we can have a whole thread about this. Sidebar, but if you haven't read this, then you need to read this. Like, if you love sci-fi. Yeah, right.
No, it was a video, my bad. Dwayne down here.
Sorry about that, guys. If you love sci-fi and you ever have felt like you're anything other than the norm, like something just, come on, Dwayne.
I hit something.
And you ever have felt like you identified with anything that was other than status quo, or you felt like people just automatically knew something was off. And when I say off, not like something's really off, wrong with you, whether you realize it or not, but just that things don't necessarily connect the way that you like, you will relate to this so much and you will just fall in love with the characters. Like, I feel like so many different people were represented in this book. It is just beautiful. Like, I cried while reading this book towards the end, not because of how beautiful it was, but because how emotionally invested you get into these characters. And like, when certain oppressions or certain like atrocities happen to them, like, I didn't expect for me to be that emotionally invested, but I literally was. Like, I felt like I knew these characters. Yeah, it just somehow was able to tie sci-fi with like raw, real emotions and feelings. And I just think this was an amazing read. So I highly, highly recommend it. Language might be a little weird at first. You'll get used to it and you'll start to really enjoy it. And yeah. Okay, this is probably the weirdest, most non-explanatory review ever. But just trust me on this. Trust me on this one. All right. Love and light, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Deuces.